Excuse me, miss. Could you help me to find the London subway?
It's called the Tube, but yes, it's right there.
What's good, YouTube? It's LUISGUSTO, Narissa's behind the camera. Welcome back to London. The Tube is one of the world's most famous public transit systems, and in this film, we're gonna give you everything you need to ride. The UK has shown us a ton of love, so we're back in London to create some incredible content. Before we scan our Oyster cards, you know what to do. Go ahead and finesse that like button, and now let's head underground. Transport for London handles all public transit in the metropolitan area, including the underground, AKA the Tube. Although about half the system runs above ground, the entire thing is referred to officially as the London Underground. There are 11 lines in all, each with a corresponding color, but they are referred to by their name. This is unlike NYC, where train lines have a letter or number as their name, and unlike Chicago, where each train is referred to by a color. Trains indicate their direction and final station. For example, an eastbound District Line train to Upminster. In general, lines travel in two directions, but keep in mind that sometimes they split, so the same line running in the same direction will have multiple terminal stations. Every single underground line travels through Zone 1, which is the central zone. There are 9 zones in all, and they increment as you travel farther away from the City of London. The genesis of the London Underground was a proposal in the 1830s in order to combat congestion from omnibuses, carts, and pedestrians traveling to and from the city. Metropolitan Railway received permission in 1854 to build an underground railway, but first they constructed a test tunnel in Kibblesworth, a small town with similar geological conditions and one that my puppy might like to visit. 1863 was the year that the Metropolitan Railway began service, the world's very first underground railway. Initially, underground lines were built using a method called cut and cover, digging trenches through existing right-of-ways just below the surface. This was necessary because the first trains were actually steam locomotives and they needed lots of ventilation. As technology advanced, trains could be electrified and thus deeper tunnels were dug. The shape of the tunnels actually gave the system its nickname, the Tube. Once upon a time, the multiple underground lines were run by independent companies, but over the decades, they were run by a single organization, like the London Passenger Transport Board and the Greater London Council. Today, everything is run by Transport for London. There are 11 total underground lines: Bakerloo, Central, Circle, District, Hammersmith and City, Jubilee, Metropolitan, Northern, Piccadilly, Victoria, and Waterloo and City. Yes, I did that all in one take. Each one has a corresponding color, which you'll see on the maps, in the stations, and on the trains themselves. The Tube has over 1.35 billion annual riders, and the system as a whole is about 400 kilometers. That's 250 miles for my American friends. Trains travel at an average speed of 33 kilometers per hour, and the busiest station is Waterloo. In general, trains run from about 5 a.m. till just after midnight, give or take, but on Fridays and Saturdays, there's a service known as the Night Tube. Multiple lines run in 24 hours. That's a pretty convenient service available to you after a long night of drinking at your favorite pub. Unlike New York City and Chicago, where train stations are named after the streets that they're on, London Tube stations are named just a bit more cinematically. They could be named after an area, a landmark, nobility, and yes, sometimes even pubs. For this reason, London Tube stations do not repeat, unlike NYC and Chicago, where you'll have multiple stations named Western or Canal Street. You cannot use cash directly to ride the Tube. You can either purchase a single ride ticket or use a contactless form of payment like credit card or phone wallet. But the best option is to purchase an Oyster card. Visitor Oyster cards can be bought in advance and shipped to you anywhere on the planet so that they're ready to go. Or you can buy an Oyster card at a variety of locations, including most Tube stations. Just like the US, you must scan your form of payment at the entry gates in order to begin your journey and go down to the platform. But unlike the US, you must scan once again before exiting the station. This will end your journey. As far as the cost of a single ride, this can get a little bit complicated, but what I found is that using an Oyster card to travel within the same zone is about £2.50. But online, you can find a fare calculator so that you can plan your journey and see exactly how much your trip will cost. And also keep in mind that the Oyster card has daily and weekly caps on how much you can spend. So the more you ride, the cheaper it becomes. What's the dilly, yo? We hope you're enjoying this film. If you could do us this one favor and hit that little red subscribe button. We're trying to reach 100,000 by the end of 2022, and we could really use every single subscription. We appreciate it from the bottom of our icy hearts. Kids under 5 travel for free without a ticket. Beyond that, older kids, students, seniors, and veterans can get free or discounted travel. Check the TFL website for more details. You can buy a travel card that may help you save a little bit of money. You can get a group rate, 7-day, monthly, and even annual. Unless you have a visitor version, you can register your Oyster card by creating an account with Transport for London. This will allow you to do things like top up your card and see your journey history. There is also an app. And speaking of apps, I love to use City Mapper to plan my journey and see the train arrival times. But the train arrival times will also be announced at the station. At certain stations, you could transfer to a different line. This will be clearly indicated by a circle on the tube map and announced on the train's PA system.
Let us know if you want a guide to London's other train systems like the new Elizabeth Line and London Overground.
At the entrance to the platform, make sure to travel through the correct gate. Some are exit only, and some even accommodate luggage, wheelchairs, etc.
If you touch in and out of the same station within a couple minutes, you should be refunded.
Make sure to avoid card clash. If you drop your entire wallet on the scanner, it might read your contactless credit card instead of your Oyster card. Then it'll charge you more. Oyster cards can be used to pay for other forms of public transit, like the bus or the water taxi.
London has 6 airports, but only one is connected directly to the tube, Heathrow Airport to the Jubilee Line.
To get to the correct platform after the entry gates, make sure to read the sign. The best way that I found is to know my general direction of travel, plus quickly double check that my stop comes before the terminal station of that particular train. In central London, sometimes taking the bus or walking is actually faster than taking the tube. Wi-Fi is available at most tube stations, but not in the tunnels. If you have a major carrier in the area, you can just sign in. If not, you can buy yourself a Wi-Fi pass. The current station and next station are announced as the train stops and starts.
Additionally, major landmarks and attractions are announced at the station. For example, Westminster Abbey and Museum of London.
It should go without saying, but during rush hour, the tube can get very busy. Think early mornings, evenings, and nights and weekends. Some London tube stations have amazing public art or fantastic architecture, so they're worth visiting on their own merit. There are no express trains. Trains stop at every station unless there's a closure. The London tube map also indicates accessible stations, visitor centers, and stations where you can transfer to other train systems like the London Overground or National Rail. In my very short tube riding career, I found it to be extremely convenient, reliable, and just slightly more orderly than public transit in the US.
Let people off the train before you board. Remove your backpack on a crowded train. Give up your seat to someone who may need it more.
On the escalators, stand on the right, pass on the left. On the stairs, move up and down on the left. At the gate, be ready with your form of payment. Don't stand around here, move down the platform. Don't put your feet up on the seat. On a crowded train, don't put your bag on the seat next to you. No smoking or alcohol on the tube. If you're gonna listen to music, wear headphones. Before the train arrives, make sure to stay behind the yellow line and always mind the gap between the train and the platform.
On a hot day, always remember to carry water.
In general, the tube is a very safe system, but you are in a major world city, so keep an eye on those belongings and always be aware of your surroundings. We hope you enjoyed this film on the London Underground, aka The Tube. Keep it locked for a London bus guide. Peace and blessings.